Dr. Sarah Shields, and I serve as the Central Region Horticulture Coordinator for the LSU Ag Center. Last year, we started research trials into strawberry varieties, and this year, we've expanded our fruit crop trials to include blueberries. Who doesn't love blueberries? Blueberries fall into one of three main categories: northern high bush, southern high bush, and rabbit eye varieties. Here in Louisiana, rabbit eye varieties were added to the Louisiana superplant list in 2014 because they perform so well in many areas of the state. You may find varieties like Premier, Powder Blue, Tiff Blue, Climax, and Brightwell at your local nursery. If you decide that you'd like to add blueberries to your home landscape, there's a couple of key considerations to keep in mind. First of all, is that blueberries like full sun? Second, is that blueberries are shallow rooted and need well-drained soils. If you have heavier clay soils that tend to hold water after we get a strong rain, those blueberries may not be best planted in the ground, and you may want to look at growing in containers instead. Third consideration to keep in mind is soil pH and soil texture. Some of our soils in the central region are more acidic, and some people have very alkaline soils. If you have alkaline soils, it's going to take quite a bit of sulfur and soil amendment to bring that soil pH down to the ideal range, which is 4.5 to 5.5 on our pH scale that runs from 0 to 14. If you have acidic soil, you may not need to do much in terms of amendments at all. Also consider mature size of the plants. Blueberries grown in the ground may reach as tall as about 8 foot tall by about 6 foot wide, whereas those kept in containers can be kept a little bit smaller through annual pruning practices. Another consideration to keep in mind is cross-pollination. So our rabbit eye varieties tend to have better pollination and a more extended harvest if 2 to 3 varieties are planted in close proximity to each other. Final consideration to keep in mind is our actual growing zone. Here in the central region, we're in zone 8. I was looking at blueberries at a retailer recently, and I saw a blueberry variety that I hadn't seen before. So I took up my cell phone and quickly looked up that variety and found that it does best in zones 4 through 7. So in a year that we have no issues in achieving the chilling hours that plant would need, it might actually produce some berries for us. But in a year that we don't have much in terms of cold weather, we might not get the chilling hours, and then we wouldn't have a good berry production the next year. And I'd actually be more concerned about taking that plant through our hot, humid summers and whether it would actually survive and produce for me the next year. So again, going with varieties that are better suited for zone 8, and that's our rabbit eye varieties. Dr. Michael Polozola is actually going to introduce you to some new varieties on the market that are also low chilling hour varieties. Again, LSU Ag Center hasn't tested those, so we're going to be trialing some of those varieties to see if there's some that we would actually recommend to you. For now, our standard is to recommend the different rabbit eye varieties, and you'll have good success in your landscape. So with all of the considerations, I would recommend doing a bit of research. If you want to add blueberries to your landscape, see what will fit best for your site. And then you can go to the nursery and actually pick up those plants. You've done all the legwork at home in that preparation, and you go pick up the plants. Recommended that you can plant in the fall. You can also plant varieties in the spring. You can see this plant next to me just picked up, and it's loaded with berries right now. And in a couple of weeks, those will turn a nice dark purple and they'll be ready to harvest. So with that preparation in mind, it's time to go visit the nursery and pick out your blueberry plant material to add to your home landscape. After you've done your research and determine which blueberry varieties you want to add, whether they be some of the rabbit eye varieties or you want to try some of the new ones that Dr. Polozola is going to introduce a little bit later, it's time to visit the nursery. When I visit the nursery, and I like to go to a local nursery so I can actually see the plant material that's available, There's nothing wrong with ordering online. I would give a word of caution that if you do, just make sure it's through a reputable vendor. But if you go to a local nursery and you start to look at the plant material, one, you can see what varieties they have available. You can also look at the plant material in terms of the overall shape and structure. You can take notice of the cane structure that is on each of the individual plants. I always evaluate for insect and disease pressure as well. And lastly, after I evaluate all of the vegetative growth, I'll flip the plant over and I'll take a look at the root ball to make sure that I don't have a pot-bound plant. And once everything checks out, I'll make my final selections and determine which plant material it is that I want to take back to the demonstration gardens and install there in our blueberry trial.
Hi, I'm Michael Polozola with the LSU Ag Center, and today I want to visit with you about some blueberry research we're starting in the central region of the state. So we're looking at blueberries for container production and even some use in the landscape. So we're looking at ones that have a little bit more of that value added input that you can get more enjoyment to justify all that extra pruning. Like this in particular is pink lemonade. It's very striking in that its blueberries don't turn blue. They stay that pink color. It does mean they stay a little bit more tart, but that can be an interesting conversation piece and a great addition to your landscape, either in the yard or in the pot. And then here's one I'm really excited to try later this season. It's called peach sorbet. It's got very nice attractive foliage, but it's also supposed to have a nice almost tropical hint to its taste as well that I hope really manifests and makes it worthwhile addition for a container landscape. So these are two where their value added is in their flavor and their fruit. And here are ones that have great ornamental potential either for long-term use in a pot or maintain dwarfing status. With this one, our Cabernet Splash, it has this great visual appeal with our purple. And of course in Louisiana we love the color purple, either through LSU or Mardi Gras. We like to incorporate it in our landscapes. And this material maintains this purple hue that normally only manifests itself as the trees are going into dormancy throughout the growing season. So it's a great addition, great visual appeal, great use in a pot. And we also have, some people are looking for boxwood alternatives. This blueberry here has the nice pointed leaves, and if trained right, could be a nice hedge suitable for replacing boxwoods if you have high disease pressure, and if you just want a hedge that gives you an upside with the fruit in it as well. This one here that I need to pot up soon is called Silver Dollar. It has nice rounded leaves and almost eucalyptus-like. It's described in some descriptions, not quite as pronounced, but it creates visual interest, which would make it worthwhile as use in a landscape in a pot to be appeal, even if you wanted to cut some and use some for floral arrangements. And then going back to dwarfing, this is one of the dwarfing selections I'm looking at called Southern Bluebell. So it's supposed to stay nice and compact, very well suited for container production, and even have a lower water demand because of the resulting smaller size that it keeps. We're wanting to trial it for you and find out, in our climate, in our weather conditions, does it maintain the nice good disease resistance and does it maintain that small size? You'll find that some material marketed as miniatures end up getting quite large in our area just because of our climate. So hopefully in a year or two, I'll be able to give you an update and say, yes, this does stay small and you can incorporate it into your patio plantings and be able to grow blueberries where you normally couldn't, either due to space limitations or soil pH. This has been Michael Polozola with the LSU Ag Center visiting with you about our blueberry research we're conducting in the central region.